there's a really challenging situation in Lebanon because Hezbollah have been living inside the Lebanese governance structures within the Lebanese state like a parasite almost. And they've rendered the Lebanese government particularly impotent in this situation. And they also have a habit of carrying out assassinations of political rivals. And so it doesn't really suit the Lebanese government to acknowledge their level of powerlessness, and it doesn't suit them to speak up too loudly against Hezbollah in case there are repercussions.
So does that mean that Hezbollah has free rein then of the country?
Yep, pretty much. They're effectively the most powerful entity in Lebanon, including the Lebanese government.
My goodness, that's actually very concerning, isn't there? I mean, what are the people in Lebanon calling for, and what are the solutions that I guess the government will be looking at in terms of trying to take power away from Hezbollah?
Well, Lebanese society is extremely diverse. They've got Druze, Christians. They've got Palestinian Arabs who were moved there after 1948, and then again after Black September, when they were thrown out of Jordan after the civil war there. So they've got a quite varied range of public opinion. The one thing that possibly would unite that public opinion is if Israel moved beyond a very limited border operation in the south with ground troops. That's the one thing that would really upset people, because they have long memories. They remember 2006. They remember 1982 to 1985 when Israel was occupying Lebanon. And they're not fans, quite understandably. So whilst Hezbollah is widely hated, and in many parts of Lebanon, the assassination of people like Hezbollah's leader was celebrated, there's a real danger that public opinion might coalesce if Israel does more than it says it's currently doing.
That's very interesting, actually, because that was one of the areas that I wanted to explore. Of course, just discussing right now the fact that obviously Hezbollah able to strike fear in the minds of government ministers and the government structure there. But then within the community, within people, it doesn't appear to have much influence at all then.
It does very much so in the areas where it's popular, which is mainly the Shia areas down in the south. And if you look at the map of where Israeli airstrikes have been coming in, it correlates really, really closely to that demographic map. That's really indicative of where their support base is. But even people who are not Palestinian or not Shia and are pro, the Lebanese governments rather than Hezbollah, still find the idea of an Israeli ground incursion quite distasteful.
And also, if an Israeli ground incursion, if things were to escalate even further in Lebanon, what are the military capabilities that Lebanon has, for example, in order to defend itself, as you would say, or to take on Israel?
Well, the Lebanese army have been noticeable by their complete absence. By all accounts, they've withdrawn from the areas where fighting is likely to be. The Lebanese army, of course, has British army mentors directly attached to them. So there's no interest in them getting into a shooting match with the Israelis. We also have UNIFIL, which is the UN force in Lebanon. They have no mandate to undertake combat operations, so they won't be getting involved in the fight either. So I think what they've done is essentially just clear the area, and they're going to leave Hezbollah and the Israelis to fight it out.